Hello, comrades, and welcome back to Steven Steve Plays Ostalgie, the Berlin Wall. We did it, guys. We made it to a third video. This is progress right here. We're doing excellently, as far as I can tell, you know. Gorbachev abandoned Comic-Con, so we built our own new council for the Council for Mutual Economic Assistance. Yeah, I forgot what it stood for a second there. And yeah, we're actually doing very well for ourselves. We've got a bunch of countries in our new union. We got Korea, we got Syria, Albania. We got a decent amount of cash. Ostalgie is relatively low. Party unity is high. Support of the people is a bit low. And standard of living is a bit low as well. But hopefully our science will... Yeah, our science is doing great as well. So honestly, we're in a very good position. We can pause, I think. And yeah, let's start having things happen. Can we support Milosevic at this point? No, because the Nationalists haven't won elections yet. So let's send them help. Let's send some help to Afghanistan. Both military and humanitarian. Alright, we can't do anything with Egypt yet. That's unfortunate. Let's start supporting Algeria, Ethiopia, Somalia, and Nepal. Let's pause for now. Alright, so we can't do anything with Laos, but we are trading with them, which is good enough for us. When can we start trading with either Iran or Iraq? Not for a while, but that's fine for us. We can't provide any more coordination between the Warsaw Pact countries. But that's okay, we're strong and stable. Yeah, things seem to be going pretty okay. We want to see how many are... We have a steady growth of agents, which is good. We can support the left wing in Algeria. We want to keep doing that. Because there's an achievement for supporting all of those countries. 200%. Someone on the Steam page, when I started a discussion to try to get people to, you know, check out the series, and somebody mentioned that we might want to change our advisors, or rather the people in our government. So we have Stoff, supporter of growth of profit. What about this moderate reformist, Gorbachev's friends? Yeah, I don't feel like we want these people at all. And there's Hager, or Hager, professor of wallpapers. Yeah, I want him. Let's see, fighter for automation. I guess we would want that. I imagine that will speed up research. That's good. Yeah, okay. We did that. That lowered party unity a bit. But that's fine. Honestly, we should be okay. Let's see, is there anything we can do in Japan? No. Okay, so, March. January, February, March. April, rather. Yeah, I'm not good with my months. Let's see, something's happening in Hungary. Hero killer. According to our information, Károly Gross, General Secretary of the Central Committee of the Hungarian Socialist Workers' Party, received from the Soviet leadership archival data on Imre Nagy, the man who led the Hungarian uprising in 1956. The documents refer to Nagy's cooperation with NKVD during the 1937 to 1938 period, as well as his proactive and selfless work. In addition, the documents mention the denunciation that Nagy wrote to the Hungarian communists. So, given the inner party discontent with Gross's actions, as well as his desire to preserve socialism in Hungary, they could play in strengthening his position. Yeah, we will absolutely give it to him, and he will publish them. That strengthened the socialist camp, which is great. Science is finished. Let's research. Ooh, should we do cyber sin or people's satisfaction? I think we'll do this because this helps fight Ostalgie. What's this then? I'd like you to stay. 45 years have passed since the end of the war with the Third Reich. But today, one of the SED deputies made an unusual initiative. He called the 20 years ago Yulian Semyonov's Seen Moments of Spring was published, in which a cult television series was filmed. Yeah, that's great. I've actually... It's spawned a lot of very famous jokes and parodies in Russia. And he offered to put a legendary movie hero monument near the oldest restaurant in Berlin, in which the hero loved to visit. Yeah, build a cafe and... Yeah, great, why not? Increased nostalgia a bit, but we should be fine with that. That increased support of the people. And support of the people is actually rising now, which is great. Let's see our number of agents, too. Oh, sorry, I'm just enjoying a massive mug of tea. Let's support the left wing here. Okay. And now we can actually start extracting resources from Algeria. That means that will hopefully help us with money. We're making great amounts of money right now, so we could build something, but we don't really need to be honest. I mean, we could build a TV center, but we don't need to. I think we should build an army base, because that gives us... it helps fight Ostalgie and gives us agents, which is obviously a good thing. Both of those things are great, so why wouldn't we want them? Can we do anything in Greece? Let's wait for the USSR to leave the Warsaw Pact, which will happen in about a year's time. Let's see, Hungary is doing fine. Can we finance any of them? No, we need to wait until the next year. That's fine, that makes sense. Can we support anything? Alright, let's speed up time a little bit. Until we get one agent network. Can we support the communists in Germany? Yep, great, that should be nice and helpful. Sorry for that crackling noise, by the way, if you hear it. There's something wrong with my hard drive, unfortunately. There's nothing I can do about it. Okay, so, May, nothing's happening, we can speed up time a little bit. We could start trying to help conservatives in the USSR, but honestly there's no point. Let's boost our left wing in Algeria for a bit. Excellent, it's at 100%. And now we can start doing it in their other countries. Ethiopia. It'll take a while for them to reach 100, but hopefully we'll be able to do it before the end of the game. Anything else we can do with Korea? No. We can't do friendship with anybody. And we don't really need to. I suppose we could start building a nuclear technology already, because that makes us very powerful and sovereign, and basically negates the threat from Moscow or NATO, which is great. So yeah, we should look at that. Ostalgie is dropping sharply, something is happening in Romania. An ace up the sleeve, the general secretary of the RCP, the Romanian Communist Party, in order not to aggravate the situation, did not nominate himself as the candidate for the presidency, approving Manea Manescu for the post instead. According to our information, Manescu is only an intermediate candidate, and after 5 years, Ceaușescu plans to nominate his son for the presidency. If this emerges in party circles, we'd have a chance to provoke a backroom resignation of Ceaușescu. Yeah, provoke the overthrow of Ceaușescu's support, Gheorghe Apostol, Stalinist. Ceaușescu's plans became known to the highest circles of the RCP. While Ceaușescu was on a business trip to Iran, he was removed from all posts at an extraordinary congress of the party, and the group of Gheorghe Apostol was rehabilitated, and George himself became the new general secretary. Despite the fact that the debt had been paid back, the treasury began to fill with gold under the new regime. Yeah, everything's great. So Romania is now in a firm, strong position, shouldn't fall to revolts anytime soon. Ooh, Afghanistan. Afghanistan. Almost 10 years of Soviet Union fought against the Mujahideen. With the coming to power of Gorbachev, it was announced that it was preparing to withdraw all the forces. Basically, it means we want to support Afghanistan, and yes, we want to encourage the fight in Afghanistan. Basically, it means that we're sending support to Afghanistan, which is great. So if we look at the view and then we look at situations, control in Afghanistan is at 75%, which is awesome. So hopefully we'll be at the top before we finish this game. We can speed up time a little bit. We still got about a year before the USSR collapses, so we should be fine. Let's see how many agents. Yeah, we're gonna want to build more agents. Or at least do something to make more agents. Foreign Intelligence Department, yep, perfect. Although I suppose I should have probably built an army base instead. Yeah, I mean, the army base seems just better in general. So yeah, we'll build another. Yeah, again, I'm sorry for that crackling noise if you can hear it. Yep, Ostalgie is steadily decreasing. Support of the people is in a good place. Standard of living slowly creeping up. Not great, but going up. And, oh, it will start going up very soon now with our genetic engineering done. All right, so that's an event for the genetic engineering. Let's see. New generation. Comrade Honecker achieved the impossible. Genetics has now grabbed not only the minds of our scientists, but it is also ready to grab our economy. Basically, this means should we upgrade all our farms? And yes, we should. Upgrade all our farms, that makes them a lot better. So if we look now, genetically modified farm. The budget plus 0.3, which is awesome. Ostalgie only plus 0.1, and standard of living plus 0.2, so this is great. We might as well want to build a few more of those, because, I mean, honestly, we can afford it. And let's start researching Cybersyn. And yeah, we might want to build a few agricultural sites. Agricultural establishment, yep, great. Because we're fighting Ostalgie very effectively, so that should be no problem. Alright, something happening in Iraq. Hussein's decision. In the past few months, Iraq has openly provoked the Kuwaiti government. Basically, do we want to support Kuwait? And yes, we do. Because now he's trading with us, which is awesome. He's not in our union, but he is trading with us. And we'll be able to soon be, at some point, be friends with Iran as well, which is also a great thing. But not yet, obviously. Everything is going very well. Party unity is high, everything else is pretty good. Let's see, can we support Milosevic yet? No, the nationalists have not yet won the elections. I don't know when that happens, but it hasn't happened yet. Alright, anything we can do with France? No, anything we can do with Switzerland? We can siphon money into the budget, but unity of the party is good, so we don't need to waste that money on that right now. Or at all, really. Let's see, who are we trading with? Yeah, we're trading with tons of people. Alright, let's, how many agents do we have? 8 agents, perfect. Let's start supporting left wing in Ethiopia. I think it's a lot more efficient to just kind of bump it all up in one country. Just kind of focus all your resources on it, but who knows. It starts declining again. If you can see here, the leftists are 98%. But I think it declines a lot slower the higher it is. But I'm not sure. I cannot confirm that for sure. Alright, something happening in Yugoslavia, finally. The farewell of the Slavyanka. Thanks to the skillful policies of Josip Broz Tito, the national question has ceased to be a problem in Yugoslavia. However, Tito was unable to create an institution of succession, and after his death, the new Yugoslav government failed to competently govern the country, because of which the national question again surfaced in Yugoslav society. At the, 14th Extraordinary Congress, the LCY actually ceased to exist as a single party. Even before the Congress was over, the delegations of Slovenia, Croatia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, and Macedonia left. After that, the Republican organizations of the LCY began to turn into independent from the center parties, each of which had its own peculiarities and acted on its own. Soon the first multi-party parliamentary elections were held in Yugoslavia, as a result of which opposition nationalist parties gained a majority in the parliaments of all the republics except Serbia and Montenegro. Provide humanitarian aid, do not interfere, provide all-around assistance to Milosevic. Yep, that's what we want. Yeah, basically, Yugoslavia is in a bit of a shit situation right now, and we need to provide... I don't know what happened to the music just there, that was a bit weird. But yeah, we will help Milosevic, we'll provide all the help we can. Hopefully they gain control, let's see. Yeah, control Yugoslavia 90%, so that shouldn't last too long. Let's spend some more money on Ethiopia whenever we can. Speed up time a little bit. Yeah, standard of living is growing very healthily. Ostalgie is decreasing. Support of the people is growing. Everything is perfect. Alright, so soon we will have researched Cybersyn, which will greatly boost our economy. And I mean, we'll have 25 money soon, so we might as well buy those nuclear technologies. Because why not, really? It's better sooner than later, I suppose. Alright, something happening in the GDR. One and indivisible. More and more countries in the socialist camp are taking the path of reforms. No, we cannot allow... Start the persecution of supporters of this association. Excellent. So that decreased Ostalgie, I think. No, it didn't, actually. But that's fine. We're not gonna join the GDR because... the FRG, because, I mean, why would we? They're horrible. So let's see, I think we don't have any borders that are open, do we? Yeah, no, we don't have any borders open at all, which is good. Let's see statistics. Yeah, we're doing great. We're doing a lot better than the real GDR was doing, under the wise leadership of Comrade Honecker. Okay, our money is in... We've got buckets of money, so we might as well buy the nuclear technologies at this point. Because why the hell not, really? Let's see, can we do anything with Iran? No, our diplomatic reputation is too bad. Alright, end of Thatcherism. Urgent news, it seems that the split in the Conservative Party of Great Britain is ripening. between the Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher and her deputy Geoffrey Howe. Basically, this is people trying to, the party getting trying to get rid of Thatcher. But Thatcher opposes German unification. So we will support Thatcher in the vote. Despite her efforts, Margaret Thatcher was removed. Oh well. No matter. We still won't reunite with the FRG. At least not on their terms. If an opportunity presents itself to overthrow their government, we will, but as far as I know, that doesn't happen. Yeah. That's how many agents we have? 6.7. That's really not a lot. Like, how are we producing so few agents? Let's improve this city and build... Right, and another army base. That should really help us grow agents and crush Ostalgie even further. Alright, Cybersyn is research, and let's research SORM or SOIA. So, let's see. Allende's legacy. Comrade Honecker achieved the impossible. He managed to repeat the feat of Allende, overthrown by the neoliberal military clique. Our aspirations have not been in vain, and now we can achieve prosperity through effective, fast, and mathematically accurate work. Yes. Build a Cybersyn. Ooh, the party hates us. Ah, this is the time to use those Swiss banks. Ooh, this is dangerous, dangerous, dangerous. Let's see. Bank. Come on, party. Like me. Let's be friends. Excellent. We managed to save the situation. But now our economy should be doing excellent. And look at the standard of living. Oh, 82. That's perfect. That should really help us increase support of the people. But yeah, Cybersyn is great. Yeah, this is perfect. We're about to finish the year, which is great. How many agents we have? We can't afford the nukes at the moment, but that's okay. Well, not the nukes, but the nuclear technologies, so to speak. Christmas, 1990. And yeah, I think this is a good time to end this episode. New Year's, 1990. The next year will be quite, a basketful of crazy stuff going on. The Tsar will fall, there's a lot of stuff that's gonna need to happen. We're gonna have to build a new Warsaw Pact. And that should be exciting. So yes, hope you enjoyed this. Like and subscribe. Leave any comments, suggestions, or tips, or questions about the game in the comments below.